Hey everyone, in today's video, I want to show you how to add H1, H2, H3 tags in your WordPress post. Now, I'm sure you are a little bit familiar with H1 tags and you're looking to add them into your post, which is very good. So I'm going to show you a little bit about H1, H2 tags, just where to add them and how they're used by Google and why you even need them. So H1 or header tags are just that. They're kind of like subheadings, kind of like what you see right here. They're subheadings and you can add subheadings throughout your blog posts, and they're good at separating your topics. So if you use these type of headers throughout your blog post, maybe you decide that you have four different topics that you want to talk about, same topic, but you know, you want to break it up into four different subtopics, then you can do that on a blog post. And the great thing about headers is that you want to be able to use headers that Google sees as relevant and that Google can read to be able to tell what your post is about. So one of the things that you want to do within your headers is you want to add keywords. And keywords are really important because it's going to let Google know exactly what your post is about, and also it helps for the ranking factor. So let's start taking a look at some of these headers. If you want to look up here at the top, you may want to add your H1 tag or your first tag at the very beginning of your blog post. So as you can see right now, this post is about network marketing tips, the fastest way to succeed in network marketing. And I put that title right here. And so this title right here, right now, because I've changed it, I had it as an H1 and now it's an H2, but I'm going to show you how to change it. The way that you change it is go to the tab that sits right up under Add Media, and you will see where you can click this arrow and all of the headers will come up. So you have heading 1, heading 2, 3, 4, 5, and it goes up to heading 6. And I don't think you need any more than that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click heading 1, and it's going to change it right here to heading 1. And so this is important because every blog post should only have one heading 1. You shouldn't have 2 or 3 or 4. So the heading 1 is here. Now, if you're working, of course, inside of WordPress, there is another way to utilize the heading 1 if you don't want to use this. So I'm going to show you how that will look if you're not going to use your heading here. You can also use what's on your title page. So let me show you what that is right now. I'm going to open up a new link, and I'm looking for it right now. Got quite a bit of posts here. That's my offer. So here it is. Now I'm going to click on this. And what you will see at the very top of the page is the title, Network Marketing Tips, Fastest Way to Succeed in Network Marketing. Now, I already have a header 1 that says the exact same thing. And with WordPress, your title kind of acts as your heading 1. So I don't want to have two heading 1s. As you can see right here, it's written once here. And then, of course, I have it in the title. So I kind of want to change this, and I'll end up keeping this the same, but more than likely what I'll do is change this title and just make it an H2 and then continue from there, because the title page, pretty much in every single page, you have a title that can act as a header 1. But I'm not going to get too far into that. I want to show you the basics of the H1, H2, and H3. So let's get back to it. Okay, so now that you know how to add the H1, then you need other subheadings. The second one for myself is Network Marketing Tips for Beginners. I would make this one the header 2, which is what it is, heading 2. It's already highlighted. Just click the button, add heading 2, and there you go. And do all of them like that. Scroll down, and then you will see that this one right here is my third subheading, and you can see it's heading 3. It's already highlighted. How do people succeed in network marketing? Like I said, you want to put all of your keywords in it. And this, of course, goes all the way up to heading 6. Whatever you feel that you need to do to break up your blog post, you can do so. You can see, too, that these 7 or 8 tips that I have, they're not the ones that will have headings to them. So they don't necessarily need headings. And I'm going to scroll down and show you where your next heading would be. You can have a heading 4. I have quite a few of these. And at the very end of my post always, I have my final thoughts. And this one is going to be always my last heading. So looks like I broke this up into 5. So I showed you heading 1, 2, 3. Heading 4 is somewhere in between. And then, of course, my final thought is always heading 5. And in my final thought, like I said before, I'm always adding my keywords, which is right here, succeed in network marketing. So whatever your keywords are, you go ahead and you add them. And this is how you pretty much add your heading 1, 2, and 3. Like I said, it's very simple and easy. Once you get done, make sure that you update so that you can save all of your edits. And that would be pretty much it. Now, these are great tips, of course. If you're starting out, you want to make sure that you are following this. And to give you more information on that, make sure that you are, you know, checking out all of my videos and make sure that you follow up with the blogging video specifically. Now, if you like this video, make sure that you check out my other video right here, Tips for Success in Your First Month of Blogging. I give some really, really good info on the things that you should be doing, such as that keyword research and having your keywords in the right places. You want to make sure that you are definitely doing that because we don't want to create content that's not going to rank, right? So we want to make sure that we've got that content ranking and we're getting the results that we want. All right, guys, so give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and also make sure that you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you don't miss out on any future episodes. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video.